Andrew Foster, a.k.a. Rube the Genius. Rube Foster, without question, the greatest baseball mind this sport has ever seen, and virtually no one knows anything about it, even though he is rightfully enshrined in the National Baseball Hall of Fame. Rube Foster is that rare baseball personality that would have checked all three boxes in terms of Hall of Fame credential. Oh yeah, he would have gone in the Hall of Fame as a pitcher, as a manager, and as an executive. But Foster was best known as this visionary, this tremendous leader. He would organize the Negro Leagues in a meeting held in Kansas City, Missouri at the Paseo YMCA on February 13, 1920. He would rally eight independent black baseball team owners together. And somehow or another, he convinced them that in order for black baseball to succeed, they needed an organized body. Rube would become president of the Negro Leagues. Rube Foster, arguably, is the most influential person in baseball history, simply for what he did in forming the Negro Leagues. Rube Foster is believed to have created what we now know to be the screwball. Back then, it was called a fadeaway, and Rube perfected this pitch. So much so that the great Major League manager, John McGraw, would sneak Rube into his camp so that Rube Foster could teach Christ Mathewson how to throw the screwball. Christ Mathewson threw the pitch all the way into the National Baseball Hall of Fame that he learned from Rube Foster.
Got him.
He earned his nickname, Rube, as a youngster there from Calvert, Texas, when he beat the great major leaguer, Rube Waddell, in a head-to-head matchup, and the nickname stuck. He also had the full repertoire to go along with this unique pitch that he created called, back then, a fadeaway. And so, yeah, Rube doesn't get nearly enough credit for having been one of the most dominant pitchers in black baseball history.
Nope. over.
Rube Foster owned the Chicago American Giants, and he managed the Chicago American Giants. And his savviness, his craftiness, his astuteness of the game allowed him and his teams to dominate the early era of black baseball. Rube assembled some of the greatest talent in black baseball history for his teams, where he served as both player and manager. He knew great talent. He knew how to go out and recruit great talent and build the kind of chemistry with that great talent of starters, thoroughbreds, who could flat out get the job done. As a manager, Rube Foster was known to fine his ball players as much as $5 at the turn of the early 1900s. If you were tagged out standing up, you were supposed to slide. Rube would draw a circle down the first base line and a circle down the third base line. And if every one of his players couldn't drop a bunt inside the circle, Rube would fine them. Oh, you're going to see great baseball. Oh, but yeah, you're going to be thoroughly entertained watching Rube Foster's brand of baseball.
Count of 3-2. He's dead.
Rube Foster was adamant about the style of play that would become signature Negro Leagues baseball. Fast, aggressive, daring. They would bump their way on. They would steal second. They would steal third. And if you weren't too smart, they were stealing home. And this was a brand of baseball that was drawing both black and white fans who were sitting side by side, where during that era of segregation, that was virtually unheard of. Yeah, now Rube was light years ahead of his time.
Oh.
The Negro Leagues were born out of segregation, and there was a simple mindset behind it. You won't let me play with you in the major leagues, then I'll create my own league. And Rube essentially did what others had attempted to do, but they had failed. But Rube had the wherewithal to get it done. And how he convinced those other 8 independent black baseball team owners to come together is a true testament to Rube's ability to sell this vision. And that's exactly what they did, having established the Negro National League, the first successful organized black baseball league. Rube Foster stood there and boldly proclaimed, "We are the ship, all else the sea." He was serving notice to Major League Baseball that a new player had arrived on the scene to be reckoned with. That's why I say that Rube Foster is without question the most influential person in baseball history.